to stack my paper and put my feelings in a chain. How you gonna change when I'm the one that put you on game? I only need 3 shots and we talking about practice. How you claiming you a killer? You ain't never had action. Treat your mans like social media and leave them on.
What's good, YouTube? Back with another video, you feel me? This week is homecoming, so we got things planned from Monday through Saturday. It's gonna be a fun time, you feel me? This is gonna be my first homecoming at an HBCU at Central State University. So yeah, like and subscribe, stay tuned.
You see the brand king.
We ain't
coming for no games.
Hey man.
Yes sir.
Best brand on campus.
Come shop. The only brand on campus.
What's good, y'all, man? We back with another video. You feel me? Yeah, we got coordination practice. Miss Sophomore right here.
Hi y'all.
What's good with y'all? Name and occupation.
My name's Aisha. I'm Miss College of Education.
Name and occupation.
My name is Dylan, and I'm a computer science and mathematics major here.
Are you ready for coordination?
Yeah.
And we'll see. You'll see the whole vlog on Thursday with coordination. Yeah. Start today, bro. You start today.
Why you want to record me so bad?
I'm not recording. I'm about to record everybody. She said she just want to wait, Joe. So you want to wait till coordination? You want to wait till coordination too?
Until we.
So you camera shy or something?
Yeah.
I know you're not camera shy.
Of course not. Ready to get interviewed at all times.
All times? I'm going to ask you an interview question.
What's up?
What hoes do you got on the roster right now?
I don't got no hoes. I talk to women.
What?
I said I don't got no hoes. I talk to women.
How many women do you have on the roster right now?
I ain't got no roster because that would mean they would be hoes. I just told you I don't got no hoes.
So, I mean, you can have like multiple women on the roster though.
No, too. Then they would be hoes.
They'll be hoes?
Yeah.
You think so?
I know so. What's the definition of a hoe?
Hey, somebody on the roster, you feel me? It's a lot of definitions for hoes.
Then why would I have multiple?
So you just got one person. You just got one person. You're right, I did. You just got one person on the roster then?
I ain't gonna say I got one person.
So then you got hoes then?
I ain't got no hoes.
How are you feeling for homecoming this week?
I'm excited, okay? Because my first homecoming as a Greek. And this is my first coming home.
Can I see your letters?
AK.
Thank you.
And this is my first homecoming as Miss Junior.
Miss Junior.
I'm excited for coordination. Thursday, be there.
What's good, y'all, man? We going to this phone party right now, you feel me? Afterward, we might go to house party. I might not. I got some homework to finish. But we going to see. And we on the way there right now, man.
Yeah.
Mr. Senior.
Yo.
How we feeling right now?
Feeling good, man.
Feeling good.
To the phone party. Finna turn up.
Man.
There's a lot of fun, man.
We done had a lot of successful weeks leading up to this homecoming.
My bad.
God's plan. God's plan. Oh!
I hold back.
Oh!
I feel good sometimes. I feel next down once in a row. Go down to G-O-D.
I ain't gonna lie.
I go hard on Southside G. I make sure that Northside E.
It's kind of high up, man.
Bad things. It's a lot of bad things.
It's not that wet.
It's a lot of bad things.
I should grab my phone.
No cap, I should have done the phone. Hey, you suck?
Hey. She said, do you love me?
Let's go. Hey, so we out of here. Hey, man.
I ain't feeling this. Real Lansing, man. Welcome to homecoming.
Okay, hey, y'all better tap in to Limitless Sound on YouTube, bro. Watch this whole going. Turn around. Let them see.
Y'all see.
Okay. Tap in,
y'all. Man, that was it, y'all. I mean, it was a little cool event. Pants really wet. Shoes messed up. Her Uggs messed up. Like, she just got out of the bath. But, hey, that's really it. It was cool. Rate maybe, like, 6 out of 10. So, we're going to see y'all tomorrow at this little event right here. Stay tuned. Hey, man, what's good, y'all, man? You see who I'm with right now. No introduction. But now we finna go to this little party on the yard. It's all Monday. Tuesday, we got a little Walmart adventure, you feel me? with Chris in the photo shoot. And yeah, stay tuned.
For real?
Yeah, don't cuss. Yeah,
hold on, I might see it myself though.
You ain't gonna see it.
Welcome to homecoming. Wait, what?
Welcome to homecoming.
Welcome to homecoming, man. Hey, if you ain't know about Central, then we better do. I'm sorry about the war, nigga. I'm on that. Nigga, what is a war, nigga? Metal.
She not answering the phone.
Limitless song.
No, I'm not saying all that.
What you
Anyways, it's the best thing on here.
As you can see, YouTube, that's only day one of Central State's homecoming. Today is Tuesday. Stay tuned. And we're here right now, man.
It's pretty smooth, I can't lie. I can't be driving no red.
Drop the Instagram, man. You want me to hop in right now? Sure. Oh, yeah, let me get you. Hey, drop the Instagram.
Visuals by Chris and Chris Note to First.
You feel me? We stay locked in. Hey, they said Raven and me gonna be there probably like 12:45 dressed up. So that's probably what's gonna happen. Like, we gonna be here dressed up. That's probably it.
Little light day.
Light day? So I like to hear it, though.
Right of God.
Yes, sir.
Customs
and
see your next
Gangsta Brass campus. Need some sneakers done,
hit me up. Follow me on Instagram at
TQCustomsZ.
Sir. You know how hard this would be?
Small little event right here, you feel me? But ain't nothing going on. We can go ahead over here. A little one for this. Nothing too crazy. I know. You're on camera right now.
No.
Say something inspirational.
You gotta give me one up there.
Up there? Yeah.
What does homecoming mean to you? homecoming means to me, like Darcy said, just getting to know everybody that goes to Central and also meeting the alumni, the people who came here before us. Tradition, it reminds me of tradition because, you know, you got the game, you got tailgate, you got the vendors coming up, so that should be exciting.
That should be.
What's good, y'all? That was basically the event. I'm about to go back out there with Royal Court attire on. And yeah, I might have it vlogged, I might not, depending on what's going on. But y'all gonna see. What's good, y'all? Back with another video.
How's it, baby? Freshman. Mr. Freshman. I clocked it, okay?
What's your name? I got your name right.
Now we here for the HBCU tour. They're finna give us another business panel at 2 o'clock. 1:49. And yeah, stay tuned.
SC represents y'all, also multi-platinum recording artists and producers and celebrity entertainers. So once again, can I get a round of applause for Mr. John C. Rose? Now, it's only right we have a mixture of people in this panel because there are a lot of strong, black, independent women who are already doing what they need to do. So all my strong, black, independent women, can I get a round of applause? So coming up next is Kennedy Rue. She is an actress, host, and presenter with more than 2 decades of experience in the entertainment industry. Her background includes her role as Jeannie in the 2003, who's in Daddy Daycare?
Yeah.
Yeah, she played that. She was on Daddy Daycare and several other Memorial acting roles, being a special correspondent for Red Copy Events on Access Hollywood, and currently working as a correspondent for Revolt Black News. So ladies, we have a female on the panel. I need y'all to give a huge round of applause for Ms. Kennedy Rue. Now, the person who's moderating this, like I said, y'all are in for a treat. A graduate of North Carolina A&T is a prime example of how HBCU background can prepare you for success in the world of entrepreneurship. Many people know him as the host of 106 in Park. He was on Think Like a Man. The Wealth of Mother's Wisdom. He's a host, an actor, an author, a journalist, and many other things. And he always, always gives back and one of the most humble people I have ever met. And he also is the national ambassador of the Thurgood Marshall College Fund. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like for you to give it up for your moderator of the day, Mr. Terrence J.
One of my mentors, Damon John, once told me that in order to really acquire wealth, you have to have at least 7 different revenue streams, right? 7, right? So whether that's real estate, whether that's investing, whether that's a little hustle that you have on the side, it's very important to diversify your portfolio with things that you can do to make money. And with that said, I want to start off with you, Kennedy. You know, you've been a very successful person in this industry, but you've also acquired a couple of different side hustles along the way. I want you to talk a little bit about that.
Absolutely, Terrence. Well, as you know, in this industry, it comes in peaks and valleys. There are times when you're working and you're making a lot of money and you're booked and busy, and then there are times where you have some time to yourself. I have been in this industry since I was a kid. I started off as a childhood actor, and I would go through phases where I was working a lot, and then there would be those times where I wasn't really working. So I had to utilize my skill set in a different capacity. I realized that I love to communicate with people, I love to tell stories, I ended up babysitting for a number of years as a side hustle. I'd always been into arts and aesthetics and being creative, so for a long time I was gift wrapping during the holidays. You know, and all of that seems like, what does this have to do with entertainment? What does this have to do with you being an actress or an honorary correspondent? But these were all moments where I could hone my communication skills, where I could get stories out of people, have conversations, get to a deeper relationship with someone I wouldn't have had if I didn't take those opportunities. So, you know, I think it's just about utilizing your skill set in a different way when you're not utilizing it the way you want to be.
Yes, I love that.
We're not from New York in here.
Woo!
Jesus Christ, killing it. So, if you're from New York or you understand what it is to be in the Caribbean culture, I'm full Jamaican. And that means my mom and dad had 7, 8 side hustles. So, from a young age, I learned what it meant to actually learn and gain a side hustle. Before identifying that, I had to figure out what my main objective was, right? Like, so for a lot of you here, your main objective should first of all be school, because right now that's what you guys are doing right now. A lot of you guys, your main objective may be what comes natural to you, right? What you're passionate about. For me, that was the practice of law. I played football with the university, pledged, did the whole thing, and them Florida boys was fast. Like, I couldn't keep up with them. But when it came to the practice of law, that to me just felt natural. And outside of that, I just built the side hustles for that. You know, I just figured out how I could provide for my family, what things or hobbies I'm going to pick up. And eventually, those side hustles started to get different streams of income that came in, right? So, side hustles are important, just as it is identifying what your why is, what your main objective is, and I'm going to look forward to diving into it more.
Kennedy had mentioned a side hustle like babysitting that was kind of a deviation from her path, but then it kind of connected all the end. Did you have a side hustle that kind of connected back?
Man, my parents have me working on everything, but currently right now, I have 2 side hustles that I'm passionate about. One of which is a nonprofit, Sade's Hope, is domestic violence for teenagers who are going through these issues. And I met this side hustle where it came to me for my work mom at work. She's actually my legal assistant. She takes care of me at work, and she's a survivor of domestic violence. And I found this calling, this side hustle where, you know, we were actually giving back to the community. So that's one side hustle for me that I'm currently doing right now where I'm not, quote unquote, you know, getting income from it, right? But I'm passionate about this hustle because we're doing something for the community. We're doing something for teenagers, like some of you who may be going through some of these issues. So I'm a Jamaican guy, I got 6'5". We can go to all of them. That's one of which that I'm passionate about.
Hey, what's good, y'all? Today, Wednesday, we got a little pep rally, a little marketplace too. With the VIP.
So,
right?
If I just said don't get me in the video,
what's good? Yeah, I'm a girl for YouTube. What's her name?
Ray.
That's it? No last name either?
No. That's lame.
Hey, lame. But yeah, that's really it. I'm going to show you a coordination practice.
Facts.
The laser zoom in on the legs.
Dana Life of Miss Thomas. Happy Wednesday. So I'm gonna take you all with me on a few meetings today. We're gonna start off with one of our homecoming events with Marauders Activity Boards. Hey, Mr. CSU. It's a little dark, it's taking a while.
It is dark, it's crazy.
Yes, yes, yes. All right, and in here we have some of our MAB's activity board. They're preparing for our Marauders Marketplace, and later we have our pep rally. So come on this ride with us. Yes, yes, yes.
Let me see the outfit.
Drip. Drip.
It's a Rosie.
Talk to him.
Okay. What's good, y'all? It's midday Wednesday right now, so you see we got the activities all the way over there. 5:30, we got the pep rally, and then afterward, we got a little more practice for coordination tomorrow. Stay tuned. Who am I here with?
Shia is risen. My name is Cheyenne Walker, and I sell keychains, large trays, jars, ashtrays, a little bit of everything for real.
A little bit of everything. What made you start selling?
I'm not gonna lie, it's a little personal, but like I prayed to God and was just like, show me something that I could do. He showed me this on Instagram and I just started doing it.
Okay, I messed with it.
got the camera.
Talk to him, Ball Out.
So my brand name, business name is Ball Out Worldwide, Ball Out NT as well. And what it means is a motivation, it's an encouragement, and it's a lifestyle. Like, I've always wanted to ball out within whatever I do in this world, and I feel like people limit the world to just the word, just to athletes. And I feel like you can use it in an everyday style. I don't feel like it should just be limited to athletes. I feel like it should be limited to everybody. Everybody should be able to ball out. Everybody should be able to have fun. Whatever they're doing, spend as much money as they want in this life and put in the work to get to that point of life. And with no stress and regrets, you feel me? It's the Reno Ball Out Worldwide.
You're not going to do a flip?
You got to talk it, and you got to commit, and you got to okay. get yourself momentum.
Let me get a good one.
You got momentum, and you got to bring it in. There you go. Okay.
There you go.
Okay, I'm good. Jordan Alexis Connolly, Jack for short.
For sure.
Homecoming at the Central State University, the illustrious. I don't look good right now because my homecoming don't start until I get my haircut. I will catch y'all on Friday.
I'm a good.
3, 2, 1, go.
Then they zooming. Hold on. Damn. Hey, take it off. Oh, Nassan got that one.
Oh, man.
Freak you.
Hey, here you go.
I go like, that just hurt me. Really?
Yes.
I can beat you.
You're not beating me either.
Let's go.
Oh, yeah, Nassan. What you gotta say, Justin?
I'm tired.
Ain't no tired. Yo, I think that's it. I think that's all.
You about to fall. You not like that,
it's
boy.
It's coming quick. Hold on, bro.
You about to fall. You not.
I'm ass as fuck.
Damn.
Hard, bro.
No, you're not good, bro. You ain't got no athletic gene in your body.
Oh, damn,
Cam. Damn.
Come on,
we
all suck.
Damn.
We all suck.
Damn.
You gotta go ahead, bro.
Game is coming back.
Mika. Man, y'all, it's a good event right now. We gonna catch y'all later at the pep rally.
Amen, say amen. Millie, you watching. Keep watching.